On Saturday, vandalized towers of a Uganda Electricity Transmission Corporation Limited on the Jinja-Lugogo line collapsed, leaving many parts of the eastern part of Kampala Metropolitan in a blackout over the weekend. The incident followed a series of other cases of vandalism on electric installations, which has left several parts of the country in darkness. Currently, 10 districts, including Mukono, Kayunga, Buyukwe, Mbarara, Busia, among others, are experiencing power shortages.
32 kV Owen Falls Lugogo transmission line was vandalized at Kivuvu village in Mukono district, leading to four towers falling on the ground on Saturday, November 12, 2022, immediately after midnight. Subsequently, the Owen Falls Mukono North Mulago transmission line was also vandalized at Nasuti village in Mukono again, leading to one tower falling on the ground on Sunday, November 13th at 1 p.m.
Minister Okasai explains that they will be switching off power in some parts of the country to ensure that those places whose power lines have collapsed can also get power.
The sector has been forced to commence power load shedding over about 104 megawatts. They have been removed from the power, from supply. We are going to start load shedding effective November 13th. In case anybody has witnessed and has experienced load shedding, the cause of it is vandalism.
Yesterday, MPs on the Committee of Natural Resources asked the Minister of Energy to finance their visit to Kenya to benchmark vandalism of electricity installations. The legislators said the Electricity Amendment Bill of 2022, which they recently passed with tough penalties on vandalism, has not worked well to curb the vice that is causing the government huge losses.
We have one line off now. Fortunately, we have had one line restored. So that one line, we will load shed at least 100 and 150 megawatts. The load shedding schedule is with Umeme. But what we normally do is to inform Umeme that we can only deliver this capacity of power. And then Umeme does the load shedding. So the load shedding is done by Umeme by turning off particular areas. Not everybody at the same time. But neighborhoods, different neighborhoods will be turned off and load shedded at different times. So if you don't have power in your neighborhood at a particular time, either during the day or during the night, that is a result of the load shedding as a result of the loss of 150 megawatts.
In April this year, Parliament passed the Electricity Amendment Bill of 2022 with heavy penalties of vandalism, including 1 billion shillings fines or 15-year jail term for anyone who is found guilty of vandalizing electricity infrastructure. However, 6 months later, the Parliament's Committee on Natural Resources is concerned that even the deterrent penalties have not helped to tame the vandalism. Rachel Nachuala reporting for the news.